Welcome to a new episode of Horus Heresy Legions. And this time, the new Warlord of the Wind, Lord of the Flies, in a little bit gameplay and tactic guide to see what he can do. It seems like, 2 days left still, and it could become the new collectible Warlord. And he's awesome. For me, I think. His special ability is to ignore. Oh, ugly boys. Combat stations. All decks to combat station. Yeah, he's laughing all the time. Yeah, his special ability is to steal 1 health with 2 energy, and if the target dies, he will create a swarm of little flies, and he's also ignoring all cost of the demons, so he can be really useful with that. So let's see how far we can get. Yeah, the enemies did you already a good turn. So I do a defense turn and attacking the warlord. With one of the best neutral cards, Duke Mortesha. Let's see. Now this first match is already difficult with him. Of course, the enemy have 2 strong troops out. I not one yet. Yeah, that makes no sense, cause the warlord can put himself a friendly to win. But no matter. It's like this guy wished it. Yeah, so we could use now. Yeah, we do endurance safety turn here. And we are back in the game. So if he cannot deal 13 damage, this will be over. If he can deal 13 damage, this will be more difficult. Okay, he got me 13 damage. Yeah, first match of the day, we let this. And again. Yes, this was a really unlucky combination. This is like sometimes in the games, you can't win always. Okay. Replacing the high cost cards. Yeah, this is a better start hand.
We surrender to the wall.
Yeah. Although luckily, I mean, the Plague Marine should always be treated in the wind with fully attack. So no time to waste and destroy. Yeah, the Wall of Death can be really annoying.
Good.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, if I'm lucky, he's hitting the Wall of Death. This is a good turn, like you put her out first, another troop, when you have a backlash troop like this, and he's down to 14. Which doesn't mean much, normally he will put out first wave now, or another frontline troop to defend himself. Now he's going to be the aggressive, which place in my hands, because without protection he will not last long. Every preparing the elite. This troop is also really nice, can be really good use with tactics. He was nerfed because before he was also dealing damage when troops were set out. So one or two seasons ago in the daily thieves was a common card. Yeah, we do now the defense turn. Perfect. That's what I wanted here. And he's down on 8. Next round, Epsilon Roar and... Oh. This is a bad turn, yeah. In this case, I will play the Elite and destroy this troop. Even more damage. And 6 damage to go. You will now destroy him with a troop or with a tactic, you don't know. Usually... No, yeah. Yeah, this is a bad constellation. I'm happy I have a frontline troop. And that's it. Which will be destroyed here, you will attack here. Yeah, if I don't get any tactic next turn, this is another loss with the Lords of the Fly here, which would be my worst run in history with him. Usually I get like 8, 7, and I had already 11 wins. But that's life. You never know what brings the cake. And he will attack me. Because I want it back. There, 7. 5. Ooh. So even if I... not enough. Only chance is to put him lucky out here. No, what's wrong? Yeah, we can consume his life, which will not help me. Only one life left. Yeah, I let this like this time.
You can't kill the rat.
I'll protect the innocent.
We have better luck this time. Yeah, this troop is also good. You just use it, destroy, and there will be another troop with one, so that's basically 3 damage. If he's... Oh, this was a mistake from him. He should have waited. Now I can destroy it, and eventually it will destroy also the other troop. No, in this case not. And I will steal life from him. So I have 1 point advantage. Next round, C-Rec, which is one of the best chaos cards in the game, because I added a leather demon with 2 less energy. Better here defense's turn first. So you can now easily destroy my shield, but the big but, I can destroy him with a crack grenade. And won't get the 5 damage. In this case, I destroy him with a crack grenade. I have unluckily no 4 troops, so I need to slash the health. Yeah, this is one of the weaknesses of high energy cards. They are strong, but also you can't use many of them. Only one per turn. It's all open. Yeah, Isharion is a waste now in this deck, or his maintains cause of your demons is already one feature of this, so ignore maintains. This is like the same, it's not needed in any way. Yeah, this could be, by the way, the worst run with the Lord of the Flies here. And he's down on 10. But still not dead. Ah, nice. My little helper here. Yeah, this is why he's so nice. Now I could put out another troop And from zero to hero, maybe now? Now you will focus on this troop here. Good, minimum damage. Really nice. Yeah, next round I will put out T Elite. And this troop still health. And maybe have a comeback. Oh, Spirit of Mars. Spirit of Mars is one of the worst tactics. Lucky me here. So depends what he have on the hand. Yeah, we steal another health point. Yeah, I let him live because maybe he will give a good tactic, he give a semi-good. Not the worst. If I'm happy, he will distract the enemy as much as... Oh, that's good. That is good. That's good for me. Oh, yeah. I don't have any of these. Oops. Yeah, there was a little breakdown, sorry guys. Don't know why. Sometimes this happened with OBS. Oh.
I salute you. I'll hold them off.
Yeah, lucky me. Rosa, this is one of the strengths, a late comeback. Try this time, we have better luck.
You can't kill the rat.
All decks to combat stations.
Yeah, good first turn. In this case is to attack him. Of course he have lethal health, so he should be aggressive. Yeah, protection. Yeah, this troop is one of the better troops at the moment in the dailies, especially when you play with Horus. And yeah, this is already much pressure here. Like before. We are not attacking me, because you know when he attacks me, I will suck his blood. But now, yeah, this is 9, 13 damage. He will put it in, maybe. Yeah, this is one of the strong abilities, and this is return a troop. That means that it's not nerfed like the ability of Ambassador Melegato. This means he can still return tanks, buildings, everything. Really sad story here. But maybe I have luck. Ah, unlucky. See, if we don't have a frontline troop, this is over again. Which was by far the worst run with the Lord of the Fly I ever had.
You are about to taste defeat.
Yum yum yum. Give me the taste. Yeah, no more problem, we have another ticket. One victory, this is the new reverse record with it, Warlord here. Oh yes, still need my Fulgrim, so still buying that crate. So let's see. Oh. Yeah. In this case, we take this new warlord. This is really nice. Oblivion Knight. There's a boss. I will take this deck here. There are many nice decks with this new warlord. This warlord has the ability to deal 1 damage and then act again, which is quite nice, I think. Helios Mortar Carrier is also one of the better cards. Here we can see his ability. I deal damage and still attack. So let's start here. Yeah, when you're down to 20 health, you should save life. Yeah, this is a good tactic. He will eat it and get himself. Yeah, I will put on the damage. Oh, nice. Really, really unlucky. Only one damage here with the defense satellite. It's the minimum amount you can get with him. Next round, mortar carrier. He will put out the elite. Maybe. No, that ugly troop. He played the deck I played before. In this case, I won't take the 5 damage. I will put in the defense turn. Yeah, this was a little safety turn here. First I dealt one damage and then another frontline troop. But I'm always one troop less, like, behind him. So this is gonna be difficult to turn, but it's nothing impossible. Oh, wow. Really? So that is a strong combination. Aye, aye, aye. Random enemy troop, yeah. Yeah, so I have now the problem, I can't let him live. So I destroy him. Put this troop out. Yeah, but still, in this case, a lot of the flies can deal 4 damage anytime. Oh, yeah. What a really nice combination here of the Alad with the Berserker. And the Bloodthirst. And everything is a ship. What do you need? Yeah. Okay. Just for, let's see what he make. Okay, this comes from nowhere. No. Oh. fleet of the day with that warlord. Okay, there's a little bit better star hand. Ambassador Meligatra is really useful. Maybe one more troop which is more helpful for the start. Save more life now. Like you see, like yeah, everybody is playing Lords of Fly. Of course, it's pretty tough. Like again, I'm gonna save life. Will eat it. I will put out my corny. And the Nurgling, of course. If you put out something dangerous, I will use Ambassador Meligatra to keep it away. Yeah, I try to not destroy this troop by myself, because only if I let him live, only by backslash if it's opponent's turn, only then he will go back to your hand. Especially on the beginning, many do this mistake. Now he will come back to my hand. He will attack here or my warlord, depends on his playstyle. So this also will come back to the hand. In this case I play the mod. Area. Of course he's dealing at the end of the round 3 damage, which is quite fun. Yeah, the defensive turn means I try to protect him one more round so he could deal 3 damage. In this case, the wall of dead bodies were destroyed. And yeah, the Gitari Protector can still deal damage next round. The Zagatari didn't hit the right run. We have now two tanks. In this case, I'm gonna play this well. Good. They're gonna miss this. You have to remember, many people know it, that the Ambassador Malgator doesn't put in demon troops. So that means if you put in demon troops, this will not save you. He can't put in any demon troops. Assad is only in infantry. So next round in combine, this is exactly the turn he needed. So I need Mechanicum. It's a demon. Really? Yeah, that's bad. I didn't know this is a demon. So we put out this troop and trying to defend and give some damage to the Lord of the Flies. Bring 7 damage through. Still, this won't save him now. But we are not finished yet. This little Nurgling here. Annoying Nurgling. Yeah. Okay, I have only this turn left here to win this game. So I try my best. I'm lucky for that turn here. I put him in. And this is the special ability. Glad that I can show it. I will use 2 times attack, and I can still use it 1 more time, and if I like, I could still use it here, and then I can kill him just in time. Oh, was a masterclass player, so we can see masterclass at the moment is rank 1, so this troop is pretty good. I keep one of that because, yeah, I keep them both. I like that. This troop here can be really annoying if it's out because of his 5 life points. In the daily it's like useless, but in the event it's really nice. And again, Lord of the Flies, like I said. We deal 1 damage. He will eat 1 damage back. Safe, okay. Now I like this to clean the board. We deal 1 damage and then destroy this troop. We will need this board clean. let's have the first safety turn. D1 damage. Yeah, he did one damage because when he's attacking with a troop, oh, hit me please, ah, oh, fuck, then I can kill him easily. Yeah, what I do now? Yeah, I can play a little bit poker, give me luck, I was lucky. No problem at all this time. I will destroy this. Since he's stunned, no problem. Next round I destroy it. I don't want the Sicari Protector be in again. I play like this. Would be the best choice, because otherwise he would just attack him. Then he has only 2 life left. It's an easy target. So next round I need to heal. Yeah, I need to heal. Put out another troop. Maybe attack one Nurgling, just because he's a Nurgling. Really annoying, this card. Also the art is pretty fine, I think. These are these little green gremlin-like things, which are really annoying. If this was a mistake from him, because normally before he do the damage and destruction, he put out the wall of bodies. But then it will count plus 1. So in this case I make the defensive turn. Round Corrier Set or Doombringer. This is a pretty one, an old card, I think was already in the beta. Of course, usually when at the end of the turn cards have a black energy sign here, like that here, I think. No. I think yes, I think for the Iron Heads you can see this black energy sign under them. Oh, pretty, pretty, yeah. Yeah, I tried to deal more damage since you have nice lucky me here. Close. I could clean the board here. Thank you. Yeah, to activate pressure. But he will put troops out now. So let's hope for the best. If he can deal 14 damage, it's over for me. If not, I can maybe destroy him. Good. So I will destroy this with my bare hands. Destroy that here. He will destroy another troop. I hope that one. Nice. And another turn, some damage will be dealt. And he's down on 21. Next turn, if I can get these two troops through, I could be able to destroy him. But yeah, okay, he will destroy him. No! He's greedy. Greedy here. Okay, we are down to 12. Even if I do it two more times, 8, 7, one attack, then I must be really, 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 really lucky. Yeah, but the only chance I have. Even with Epsilon Roar outside, this would not be enough. It's close, close, close. Yeah. Difficult. A better start in here now.
Protect the innocent.
So we have still one life left. Pretty fancy here. Helios Motar Carrier already there. One of the best cards in the game so far, I think. Of course, it can attack at the end of the round and also attack by himself. In this case, we're keeping the board clean. And he's down on 28. Him again, but this nice Zagitari squad, and now we have 5 damage end of every round. This is a really good setup. If you have outflank, depends on the deck you have, it's gonna be hard. Otherwise, this you're gonna destroy any troop he's putting out. So it's gonna be already really difficult for him to win this. But nothing is impossible in this game. I had already the biggest luck shots here and also got the biggest luck shots. It's only over when the fat lady sings. Mr. Crow. Yeah, Skuitari Protector will be the next turn. Yeah, no, we're not. In this case, I need to destroy him. And I go for the damage. No, I like him to be safe. Attack here. Another. He's down to 15 now. Yeah, this is like Lucius. When you play with Lucius from the Emperor's Children, he gets more dangerous since more energy F. The same is here. Because the amount of damage can dealt is much higher than. Again, Lord of the Flies. You can't kill a Yeah. And I know how it smells. Yeah, this is also a nice one. Destroys any vehicle, have good stats, or may I have more. The health is a little bit low here, but still it's okay. Yeah, we keep him busy, we will sacrifice this squad. Damage here and heal, so I have more troops out, and more troops out is always better than using only tactics and have no cards outside, only if you are maybe Angorn or a good Exodus that can also be rely only on tactics, but should. Like these decks here, they all need. Yeah. So we put out this ugly dinghy here. Yeah, we keep the life. Can be long matches. Yeah, this is an easy choice. And we go again. Next round, I will put out Courier Theft. One damage, one. Whee! Lucky me! Oh, shit. then I do better the safety turn here again. And in this case also again, more troops out is always better because they have to deal with all of them. And so you will get overrun. The only case when you should not put more troops out is a death shroud from the death guard. Then you need only him, because he can't be destroyed. Yeah, so you will eat him. Goodbye. You are a meal. Oh, he's not a meal. This was quite an ugly turn. But, a big but, will not protect him. Because I will destroy him here. Deal here the damage. Put out the protection. Destroy him. And welcome. Yeah, let's get out the sword. Good. You were not saving life. In this case, attack here, he attack here, and we destroy everything. So if we're able to get the attack through, he is done. Ay caramba. Yeah, this is bad. So I need to take care of this guy first. Like that sad story. There was no other way. Oh, this fatty here. Yeah, the problem is now I have to put out this. Yeah, this fat demon here reminds on the traitor von Darwin. Won't help you. 6 and 2 is not enough. Victors here. Still only one life left. Yeah, first we play the abundant supplies.
You can kill the rat.
Nice again on 5 and we save life. Yeah, protecting, after that Zagitari and then Uruz Melibus or something like that, what a name. Yeah, done. Oh, in this case a little bit plan change. We destroy him because we're gonna set anyway any troop inside again. And deal 1 damage. Time for a sword slash.
Yeah.
Yeah, mobbing. Unlucky. Yeah, these troops can be really annoying because they produce one Mercandrite to your hand and with Relentless. This means they put at the beginning of the round the troop out, card out, which can be really useful. I hope this card will be it. Ay, caramba. No luck. I'm down on 17, he's on 24. It's... Yeah, he will attack here, I think. Yeah, well. Bringing the pressure in. Yeah. Uzi Malvus, Despoiler of Mars. What do you do now? Yeah, the way is clean. So he's down on 19 to 15. Yeah, he will suck its blood. Maybe put out another troop. Ugly guy. Not okay. So yeah. Yeah, we'll keep him busy. Turn.
Yes. Yes.
Mark of annoyance. We destroy him with a grenade. And we need to protect. And 9 to 15. One more troop out. Let's see what happened next. Oh, maximum damage here with the defense satellite. Really unlucky. Thank you. Yeah, no decision turn. If he... Oh, come on. That was the perfect card, the perfect situation for him. Good job. Oh. Yeah. Yeah, this was not so successful like usual. Still 50 minutes to the dailies, but no more. And I will grind because I dropped. I was really testing this season with Horus, and there was no really way to build him. Like, his Whisper of Chaos is working. I tried a lot. I have one deck which is really good working. In the air, we'll just play a little bit, grind my way up back into the top 50. Yeah, I'm going to.
You won't disobey me again.
I am done with being your warthog.
Yeah, versus Angorn, it's important that you save life. Otherwise, he will consume you. Yeah, trying to make as much damage as possible. As fast as possible. He's down to 19. Yeah, Miara in combination with Sons of Horus can be really nice. If I'm lucky, 1-1-1-1-1-1-1. So unlucky. Oh man. Yeah, this is really unlucky. You get the maximum damage on my card and I get only one damage. Ay, ay, ay. 11 to 15 now. A good comeback here from this annoying guy. Angor. Close. Mandragorax. Yeah, good start end is okay. Versus Mandragorax will be really useful to have many troops out, but this deck is more built on damage. He's also one of them cards which have many tactics usually. If we use a tactic, maybe. Otherwise, he will shoot at me. Yeah, our cut. And he's saving. Yeah, this is a nice combination. Next round here, Banestrike rounds, 9 damage. Shoot or he will use a tactic again. Oh, we do the mirror turn, also nice. Yeah, in this case I save the band strike and put him down. He will shoot with his ability, maybe, or he will put out another troop. Yeah, and rifle. Oh no, I got a safety turn here. And he's back in the game. Yeah, to put out Delta Omega is not as useful. Because of his warlord ability, so we're saving it. And do another damage. Okay.
Let the galaxy burn.
I need to put him down. One more tick. Again, healing and warlord ability, and maybe a troop. Tactic also good. No, it's good. Ah, okay, this is gonna be really close now. This new card is really good. Oh, nice. Not a tactic. Yes. Okay, good job. This is why this is... difficult in the end of the season to grind up. I found out like in the dailies you get somehow, for me I think, easier opponents. I get the dailies really fast. and then I need to grind further, and then it's sucking. Like one, two wins, one lose, one, two wins, one lose, one lose, two wins, like this. Maybe it's also then you overplayed and the focus is lacking. So the best you derive with playing the dailies.
History will be made here.
And only at the beginning you are pushing. Yeah. Now you come, Wengful Spirit. I needed you before. Yeah, this is also a good trick, like if you have some card who gives you back, then you can use it for your purpose. And we draw one card. And we go on. Yeah, Yuba can be one of the annoying cards in the game. 1-6, not much damage dealt. Again, he will put the drum in, so I can deal another 2 damage. I have no fear, Horus is here, which got corrupted after Eberus put in a trap on the Darwin's moon. Okay, it is a infantry, okay. Yeah, versus infantry, Ambassa Dora Melagato is really useful. Also, really one of the best cards for beginners. This little here, this Xeni 73. And it's 34-18. 1-1-1-1-1. Ah, maximum damage here. Yeah, that's right. This troop here, this is not often seen. This null energy will make your the chaos cast the next one 2 energy left. But a big but. Yeah, I try to use it really often with Horus, but no way. Really no way. These combinations works with a less amount of warlords, so it's not useful. This is Whisper of Cars. It's really hard to achieve. Could be also buffed. this way. So next round it's over. If we cannot heal.
We meet again.
Yeah, and classical finisher. And they're gonna win. Also, the amount of points you get is really less in the later season. Good start hint here.
You won't disobey me again.
I am done with being your war dog.
Yeah, quick fire will be kept. Oh, in this case, I attack him since so you need to attack this one here again. Some energy to play this. Yeah, Angorn is one of the last warlords which works completely with tactics. One. Oh, okay. Yeah, Remia. Yeah, I like this card really much. Especially in combination with Sons of Horus, he can deal much damage. With Band Strike rounds. To each unit, really. Unlucky. So only 10 left. Yeah, that was it. We got him. Good that I keep this card, otherwise I will lose it. And it's done. Coming closer. Alpha Legion. We are many. I am Alpharius. That's okay. It's okay, start hand here.
He History will be made here.
We are Legion.
Yeah, Firewalkers is one of the best 5 energy cards. It's also really mainstream cards nowadays. Of course, everybody is playing it. But it's really strong, this why. Yeah. Typical trick here of this guy. So I use Ambassador, I put him in and I put him out. I put again the damage and he's down on 28. Next round, Firewalker. Then more attack area. Yeah, this is why you have to be flexible in this case. Yeah, because I clone my little friend here. Destroy that troop. Destroy that troop. And go on. Yeah, so second wave now I have the possibility to use him a second time like this. Which I will do direct. Down on 17. Yeah, this is a little bit overpowered. In one turn he can heal 10 life points. Yeah. Like I said, this is not normal. Yeah, 10 life points in one turn is really hard. Thank you. So he's not transforming again. It's over for him. Yeah, again, one of many. So he's already 15 points of healing. But this won't rescue him.
The day will not save you.
Yeah, we put in 3, 5. And we got still some damage on the package. But these are only matches versus 3000. I'm at 4000, so this won't bring much. This is always like 10 or 11. This is, yeah, nearly useless. This is why it's so important to grind at the beginning of the season, then you get more points.
History will be
also good start hand. Yeah, really nice. We have 3, 4 and the Torbot.
This is about victory. True victory.
Yeah, this was the only possibility to deal 4 damage on this guy, and I did it, and I gave him another 5. And he's down to 16. Down to 7. If he don't have any healing now, next turn is already over. Destroyed. Yeah, make sure that he got hit by Zagitari, so again, he's in the same position. If he doesn't go for the healing now, he will be dead. That won't save him. He will kill Zagitari. Another 4 damage, and another 3, and he's down to 1. He will need another healing. Well, the orbital bombardment will aid him. Healed 5, and another 5.
Victory! True victory!
This is overpowered. Still, he will lose. He's again down on 8. I just reduced the damage I could take. 22 damage is nearly impossible to hit in one round, so. Oh yeah, another healing. I forgot.
For the Emperor.
Doesn't matter. I'm down to 16. Yeah, the time of healing will be over. You need to deal 16 damage. Maybe he will put out the horror ring or this troop, which still not saved him.
Let the galaxy burn.
Yeah, we are on 4,000. Yeah, to get back in the 50, I need 4,100. This is a lot of grind. Course. Ugly, ugly. Good start in here.
History will be made here.
Welcome to darkness.
Yeah, this the Night Lords are at the moment, like I think, one of the most overpowered factions. Especially his Whisper is like 10 energy, heals 8. This is crazy. Also, this Mercy and Forgiveness give him so much strong abilities. Crazy. It's crazy. Your focus should be to kill him before he kills you.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's down on 21. I have 32, but he will come in the end. Nightmarish. Yeah, this here is good. Ambassador will do the job. We put in 9 damage on him. Another. And he's down on 8. And it's done. And we are on the 4,000. Nathaniel Garrow. Yeah, so also the, I would say the most played warlord at the moment. Because of his ability, when you do one mistake in the mid rounds and when he's over 8 energy, he's nearly impossible to kill.
History will be made here.
I am a legion.
Yeah, down on 15, I should make a safety turn. So I save here my life. Attacking here. And give him 5 damage. And he's down on 10. Next round we can kill him already. Let's see. Yeah, big mistake that he attacked me, otherwise he would not be dead yet. Now he's dead. Yeah, and we are on 4022. Again, Angor. Oh yeah. good start hand here. Better start
you
hand.
You won't disobey me again.
I am
perfect
start
hand. Vulcanic instability. The same, exactly the same as the other Angorn match here. In this case I was too slow, he will destroy me with one bullet shot. Oh, like this, yeah, okay. Unlucky, good started, but then in the mid game, too little damage output. First loose. Daily start in 10 minutes. Bad hand at the start, so switch is necessary. Better.
History will be made here.
Thank you.
So give me luck. Yeah, luck for me. And I clone my secretary here. And he's already down on 13. Yeah, this is why stealth troops are really good at the moment. Yeah, 7 to 20, but it's not over yet. He's fighting the Dark Axe Inferus. So it will be really difficult to deal 15 damage. I hope one. Maximum damage here. Next round it will be anyway over. I hope. Depend on what card I get. Trying his best. Yeah. That should be the end. Oh, this guy. And it's done. Close. Close match. Hey, he was so good player and was only on 3,100 points. Sometimes it's so, this is a card game, sometimes so random that even the worst low points players you play like, whoa. 2, 3, 1, 4, it's okay.
History will be made here.
Throne, I'm ready for this.
We meet again.
Thank you.
Yeah, Dagatari is doing the drop here. And 70-20.
The galaxy burn.
Yeah, it's now really close. But should be win for me. If I can deal 12 damage now. Which so far I see I got here. Let's have a look. We need 4,115. So 100 to go. Ferrus Manus, Primarch of the Iron Hands.
History will be made.
This one,
here.
For me, not so strong Primarchs. But let's see. Has really some really good troops, but the Legion all over is not the strongest. His enhanced ability is much more worth than that from Bile. I keep that. Here, second wave, because when I have Ambassador Melegadra, this can be really handful versus the big troops which he normally has. a little bit of dilemma where you, because usually you do use this to enhance. I will enhance the Terek squad again. Or put out another squad. Yeah, one of the best squads in the whole game when you have it. Draw a card and reduce cost by 2 on your deck. This means the next card will be reduced. It's really strong, really strong. To get a little bit advantage, draw an X card, and back in the game. 22-33. and back in the game again. Mighty have 10 energy, this is gonna be a hard win. But we are starters, no fear. This match is gonna be really difficult to win. Still, we have many good troops out. One from my U-Buck here generated. And you got a Muddler. Nice. Oh, beautiful. We just fighting back a little bit, but this is over. Next match.
Impressive.
We also an ugly enemy. Looks weak in the first sight, but can be really annoying. Runs never out of troops.
History will be made here.
Open fire.
Keep the board clean. Yeah, next round Firewalker, then Helios Mocha. That's why I want the Helios is so strong. With that I can destroy this troop here easily. Give him 3 damage. And another round. He will do the same move again, I think. Oh no. Okay. of fear, Horus is here. And the enemy is down. To 8.
Thank you.
Yeah, one of the reasons why Duke Morteja is really good. He can put in the troops.
Pull back.
Especially frontline troops, which try to block you. And rising higher on the leaderboard. Still 100 points to go for the top 50 again.
You
and
will disobey
Angor.
Me again.
I am done with being your war dog.
Yeah, always when the wars is played, don't attack it, because otherwise it will summon the next troop and you can use it then already. Even though in this case he gives me a really hard time because of him, but it's life. Lucky draw from him. So we are hoping that the carrier is hitting the right troop. Ah, unlucky again. Yeah, difficult but not impossible to win. Depends on what he's doing next. Yeah, and close, but win. And we are now on 4050 nearly. So not far to the top 50. Girls, I love Angorn matches, more Angorn matches.
You won't disobey me again.
I am done with being your war dog.
Yeah, nice. The fast troop. This is really good card here. Maybe he will now use it to destroy Yubak. Maybe not. Ah, even better. Yeah, the trick now is to let this troop live to deal the damage. And we are 27-30. And he's on 23. Healing will not rescue him. So we get in the dangerous area now, we make the safety turn and deal 4 damage. And let's go on. If I would now attack with Goldstone Hunters, he will become Prince Angorn. So don't do it. Otherwise I will have problems. Whoa. So let's see. Really unlucky. One energy we're missing. One tactic, one card, which gives me the thrill. Sorry, one. Good game. These are all really close games. Masterclass, but still. I need to push.
History will be made here.
There's no turning back.
Really the worst start and ever. But it's life sometimes. Oh, I got better in this moment. Oh wow, nearly the game crashed. I go, I would get crazy over this. picking up the letter. Oh yeah, this can be an ugly enemy. Let's see.
used to think there was righteous justice.
Yeah, and the daily's already done. Untouchable. Yeah, we're gonna try this deck here, Oblivion Knight. This time, it's maybe better than before. Yeah, medium start hand. Many high cards, so we change it. Both with respect. Yeah, one of the reasons I love Xeni is 73. He's one of the best one energy cards so far. Now it's only about damage. So maybe next round we can already kill her, maybe, not sure yet. Wow. He can destroy this suit. Oh, he did a mistake. He could destroy this troop. But still not enough. Sad story. Ah, so close. 7-8. If I'm lucky now, I can win. I'm lucky. And win. Luck or skill, kill is kill.
Legion of One.
Let's see now. Better. Okay, last attack. After that, I'm gonna save. Like around 20, I start to save my life. So let's see. Clap, clap. Impossible to win this match. Often the Garrow works good on the event, but this deck is good working on the event. Really not often. Usually in the event game is an easy catch. Is loyalist still leading? Yeah, the ugly fly. Let's see.
You can't kill the rat.
Thank you. Like usual, this ugly fry is hard to kill. But it's not impossible. Wow. Yeah, no wonder there's a lot of flies. Is such a favorite by so many players in the tournament. And again, only one victory. Ooh. Today was no good event day. But the dailies were better. So, let's see. Not done yet.
We surrender to the war.
Yeah, quite a good move. Destroy it, attack the warlord. And versus Plug Marine, this is better working than versus other. Yeah, protective turn here. Yeah, sometimes it's good to give a little sacrifice, but we remember that this ugly Black Marine can poison troops, so I better stay alone since my comrades are not poisoned here. Really unlucky, minimum amount of damage here from the defense satellite, only one damage, really sad. Yeah, poor deck build. Maybe Onatov will rescue me. C- course, this troop here, because of his really less health, need much more frontline troops. And this troop here only gain frontline with one energy. That's really a waste. Oh, lucky me here, but still enough to beat me. Wow, this is not my warlord. Some like them. I don't like her. It's not my thingy. Usually I like women really much. Yeah, that was it today. Yeah, really good push in the dailies, not so much in the event today. At the moment the lodge I'm playing with, the Thunder Warriors, is placed rank 14, which is okay. The top 10 lodge will get the new warlord. At the moment is this Thaddeus Fail. I think he was playable already, but what I was a little bit sad when they put two warlords against, you can decide that you have to play both, but you can't play at the moment Thaddeus Fail. You can only play Lord of the Flies, which is really good. Yeah, so guys, then see you tomorrow again on the battlefield. Lupacal.